To me, all fight, no flight means keeping your strength through tough times. I've encountered many moments in my life where I had to decide if I was going to let someone or something decide my fate. Do I run, or do I stand and fight for what I believe in? I mean, I started playing lacrosse in Denver, Colorado. My cousin Dustin gave me a stick, one of his old sticks, and I started messing around with it in my backyard. Freshman year of high school, I went to Heritage High School in Littleton. I went there for 1 year. And that year, I found out that we were moving to Manhattan Beach, California. It was an extremely tough time for me. I was going to a brand new high school, didn't know anybody. You know, not only was I changing high schools, but I was changing brand new cities, and LA was a complete new thing to me. And adjusting to kind of the LA lifestyle and, you know, the fast pace, just didn't feel like home at the time. Throughout my whole high school career, I was misunderstood. Parents didn't understand my playing style. Players hated playing against me and thought I was a dirty player. I went as hard as I could at all times. I had one speed, I still have one speed. I feel like that's what gets you noticed, and I feel like that's what's brought me my success. I continued to get better through high school, developing my game and working tirelessly on my stick skills. And then my senior year came around. Trips back east with the West Coast Stars had provided me with some recruiting opportunities with schools around the country. So I decided to take a trip back east and take a look at some schools in Maryland. In May, I jumped on a plane and flew to Baltimore.
Salisbury was playing Cortland in the national championship that year.
The day after the national championship game, I drove down to Salisbury to meet with Coach Berkman in his office.
The one thing that I thought was incredible about that moment was the day after national championship, he was in his office recruiting, trying to continue to build his empire. You know, I knew I had to step my game up, and you know, Berkman always told me, the first thing he told me was that I have to get stronger, bigger, and faster in order to play for him. Right from that point, that's really what started my drive in the weight room, you know, and continuing my love for exercising. I knew I wasn't going to start that year, but it was my job as a freshman to push the seniors and, you know, bring my young energy into the system. And it led to me being a freshman playing in the national championship at Gillette Stadium in Boston. I remember just a little talk I had with Berkman. We were in the locker room right after the national championship, and he looked at me and he was just like, I'm gonna need a lot out of you these next few years, and I'm glad you committed to this. And you know, it was a big commitment to me, but having the brothers at Salisbury that I had, being the kid from the West Coast, it just kind of showed me how there is like a family feeling in the game of lacrosse. Berkman continued to tell us, you know, you can never be happy with what you have now. He goes, I'll wear this national championship ring for one night, the night of the ring ceremony, and then it goes in the case. Because it doesn't mean anything if you don't do it the next year and the next year. After Berkman told me that he's counting on me and he's looking forward to seeing my career at Salisbury, it made my off-season training that much more focused. I visualized things when I was practicing. You know, it really gave me a sense of where I belong. My junior year, I ended up hurting my knee, and I had two knee surgeries, and I redshirted my junior year. The team ended up making it to the national championship and losing to Tufts University in the finals. And that year was a really tough year for me personally, but it also gave me the motivation I needed then to really excel me to the next level. The next year, I was extremely motivated. I had my mindset that I wanted to make it to the national championship and win the national championship game. Our junior year, we lost one game, and we won the national championship that year at M&T Stadium.
Where I remember when I was in high school, I was just coming out here as a West Coast kid, coming to watch Salisbury. Now I had won one for my own in that same stadium.
And then the next year, I think we were 24-0, won the national championship at Gillette Stadium in Foxborough. It was just a great feeling and a great way to end it my senior year. We won the national championship, and after that, I got a call saying that I would be playing in the next LXM event, the season opener in Orange County. And I was just amazed to be playing with Johnny Christmas, Kyle Harrison. It was honestly a dream come true.
I hope when kids watch me play, or I hope when any fan watches me play, I hope they say, man, Eric is he's energetic, he's tough, he's in there taking the slashes that no one wants to take. He's in the impact zone on the crease with the biggest defenders pushing on him.
What a finish by Crum. You give him any space and he will hurt you.
I want my defender at the end of the day, after he gets done playing me, to say, I never want to guard him again.
Look inside, wow. What a catch! One arm goal! That is the most spectacular goal I have seen all year, maybe ever. And again, Crum on the end of that one. I think that one might be the one.
That was unbelievable from Eric Crum.
And you know, a lot of people say Crummy, he's always in the gym, or you know, something like that. That's fine with me. I think it's a healthy place. It's a healthy outlet for me, mentally and physically. Your body's your machine, and you know, what you put in, you get out. I've seen LXM put so many smiles on kids' faces and really make some kids' dreams come true, even just tossing around with some of the LXM players or being able to take pictures with Kyle Harrison. That inspires me to continue to go out there every day and try to spread the game.
Being an attackman means that you're willing to take a beating, okay? But that's just what I do because I'm an attackman going against the biggest guys out there. You'll see us catch the ball, you'll see us put it in the back of the net. We might be getting laid out on our backs, but we pop right back up and you go back out there and do it again.
I think I can relate with a lot of the kids, especially in the West Coast, who are going through the adrenaline system. I know what it's like to not have that much recognition.
I think it gives them something to say, oh man, Eric is from the West Coast. He went to a D3 school and he's still playing LXM.
Okay, this is an unbelievable day for some of us. Focus and energy starts now, okay? It can't just come in the first 2 minutes of the game. The energy and focus starts right now with our warm-up.
I'm a passionate player and I play with high energy. I hope to be able to spread that high energy throughout my teammates, and then you know, I hope the kids can see that too, because those are some of the funnest kids to watch for me. I see a lot of kids that I can relate with because I say, man, that's something I would do, or this kid's running around there crushing kids and being a terror on the crease and being a terror on defense. I think that's fun. I love working with kids. I love being on the field. At the end of the day, that's what I'm in it for. The kids motivate me, and I hope I can motivate them. You know, adrenaline is a family. It's not just a company, it's a family. And everybody has the same goals, and everybody wants to push the sport to the limit.
I think adrenaline is about sharing the game with the kids, progressing the game in the right way, and showing the kids what it takes to get to the next level. And if at any time that I can help these kids, you know, chase their dreams, that's what I'm here for. At the end of the day, when I'm playing lacrosse, I want to be the best player. I want to be the best crease attacker on the field, but that goes for off the field as well. I want to be the best person I can be, the best coach I can be, and the best role model I can be for the kids.
Or can't find him. 15 seconds to go. Unbelievable goal! How did he do that? Crum catches the ball, does a 180 in the air, buries it all in one motion. That is maybe the most spectacular goal I have ever seen.
I'm doing something that I've wanted to do my entire life, and it's all through the game of lacrosse.
I really am truly honored to be an adrenaline-sponsored athlete. I want to continue to train hard and continue to help the company in any way I can and continue to push LXM to the next level.
I'm Eric Crum. I'm an adrenaline athlete, and my life is all fight, no flight.